We find ourselves at the home of the world's first retractable natural grass field as you get a look inside State Farm Stadium in Glendale. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Los Angeles Rams and the Arizona Cardinals. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Seven past the 30 to the 32. He was decided to hand it off that time on the run pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice steady gain.
They'll operate from the 32 yard line here, second and three. Now it's Rodgers.
Oh my God.
This is intercepted. Julian Love picks it. Return for a Rams touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He didn't have very far to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
It's up, it's good, and the Rams take a 7-0 lead.
Makes the score Rams 7, Cardinals nothing. Brandon McManus set to kick off.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback.
5-yard line.
Arizona's offense at the line, ready to get their drive started. Now Rodgers to try again after the pick six. That's going to be caught by Kirk. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Give him nine there on the first down completion. On second down, McCaffrey. Charles, they won last week despite him not running the ball well. They told us need to get him going. Runs like that help.
And they talked to us about leaning.
Hello, Joe.
Because as you noted last week, they didn't have to. Still won the ball game. They leaned on other people to give them the yardage that they needed. But they really want him to be that guy. And that's what they're doing early in this game.
Yeah. Yeah, I was muted. I was in a Zoom meeting.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together.
Oh, I'm being the lead. I ain't tripping.
Still, ended up with a solid game.
Looking to throw again on second down. Rodgers.
No, I ain't tripping. Bro, it was play action with the jet sweep, and Kendall Fuller broke away, bro, and out of nowhere, this nigga just somehow sped up and caught him, and I threw a pick six, but yeah, it was straight. He was supposed to be open, bro. He's gonna be butt naked. Who the fuck are you playing? No, he said fucking with him. What's going on? What's going on? Bro, the offense, it's so easy to run offense on this one. Like, it's almost too easy. plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now I'm about to. It's first and goal. And again, it's Rodgers. End zone, but it's incomplete.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
If you know, you know.
They'll try again here from the 7 on second and goal. Again, they'll throw with Rodgers. And it's caught. And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. Christian Kirk, his second touchdown on the season. And the Cardinals are just an extra point away from tying this game. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7.
Bro, this lag is fucking shitty, bro. Thank God I have a straight kicker. This shit's so ass, bruh. This fucking arcade ass shit. Room to run at the 50. Still going inside the 30. Even dodging. He's in.
I know a lot of special teams coaches, they just want to keep it away from him because that's what he can do.
And others have egos that their players can't keep up with. And they say, challenge him, kick it to him. The way he runs as fast as he is, I wouldn't challenge him at all. I'd do everything possible to keep it away.
He is just a blur when he gets a full head of steam, and he got a full head of steam there.
Right, crazy.
And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. Makes the score Rams 14.
Oh, so I should blame Sebastian. Sebastian's fault.
So let's try this again. After the kick return TD, here's yet another kickoff. Cardinals take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. A really nicely run drive.
But now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush, pass rush, pass rush. Whether it's the guys up front, or maybe you bring additional guys, but you've got to disrupt the timing of them throwing the ball.
We'll see if they can disrupt it here. There's a ball thrown right side and complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. That one good for 26 and a first down. At the 42-yard line. Shotgun now for Rodgers.
Oh! Oh, I thought he was running a different route. Oh, no. Damn, Joe. Oh, I thought he was running a different route.
Start defensively. Damn. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they
How is this dude, Joe?
Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at him. Instead, they read their keys well, and they took the shot down.
No, he's not. I haven't seen him run offense yet, though. Say he did what, Joe? Yeah, I can see. Yeah, he's not. That's why I was about to. I don't know what the route's called, but I was trying to go deep.
On
on second down, here's Burrow. They set up the screen to Penny. A good job defensively to hold that to 4 yards, and now it's third down.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game.
They'll need to get this to the 38. That's where the first down marker is here on third. Out of the gun, it's Burrow.
Fuck, hit that nigga, bro.
First and 10.
No, hit that nigga. Good shit.
First down is Mostert, but he can only manage a yard, and that's about it before he's tackled. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9.
That was a particularly nice play because not only was it his job to force the play inside, he was actually able to fold inside himself and make the tackle ultimately. Very nicely done.
Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right.
This nigga plays corny as fuck, Joe.
Just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out.
They ran that one well, and not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
Right, that's one way. The way offensive players can get away from niggas on this shit is crazy. That's definitely crazy. Nigga try to run a fucking pass option. What the fuck?
That's gonna leave him with a third down.
Anytime you decide to use your quarterback as a runner, most of the time when you design a play, you're expected to break a little bit bigger than this one, because when you run him on short gains, your risk reward and him taking hits, I'm not sure that's the payoff they were looking for.
Seventh play of the drive, forthcoming on third and 8. Time Burrow will look to throw, eluding the pressure right. He can run for it and he will.
Bro, I'm sick of seeing this shit.
Inside the 10, mark it down at the 9. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Here's Mostert, and he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Another shot from the 9 on second and goal. One more time with Mostert. It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a third and goal. So stuff for no gain.
No, Madden on the PS4 is so stupid, Joe. This thing is calling timeout. This is a second.
Right away, I'm throwing it. I'm probably giving my quarterback some room, sprint him out to one side or the other, and give him an opportunity. If it breaks down, he can take off and run for it.
For who?
It's third and goal.
Fuck out of here, dog. Whoa! So sorry, look at this touchdown.
Jarvis Landry, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Rams add on to their lead.
Joe, you seen that? His offense is ass.
Trying to put the pedal to the metal here. They're going to try an onside kick. The
What's up with this guy, Joe? This nigga's corny, Joe. What's up with this guy?
So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. An incredibly short kick fielded way up there. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped it to 23-yard line. Arizona's offense at the line, ready to get their drive started. And the interception last time on the opponent's side of the field, certainly not what they wanted.
Put it mildly, that is so frustrating because that signifies there's a drive going on. You're in good spot, great place to run some of your best offense. Instead, they turn the ball over.
Yeah, turn the ball over last time. See if they can avoid doing it here.
At the 23-yard line.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run.
What the fuck did I just do? Okay.
Now Rodgers, sliding out of the pocket. Open man is Kirk, complete. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
Now a play fake here on first down. Forced out to his left. Now he'll pull it down. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. He'll get eight on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
2 minutes remaining in this first half of football.
Yeah, I saw that.
We'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. Now a run with McCaffrey, and this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of two, third and one. The tackle. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding.
Oh, I fucked up.
First down marker was, and making sure they didn't get there.
I don't think anyone in the building fooled right there, as that one is going to blow up in their faces.
Wasn't so much that it looked like the offense was threatening. They were. I mean, they had great field position, but how about the defense on that one? Huge stop on third down. It wasn't just a stop. Look at the loss of yardage, and it changes the play calling and the thought process for the offense now. Big time play for the D, and now they have the advantage.
Hey, Joe, who am I playing? What's this dude's name?
It's the punter, Pat O'Donnell, to kick it away.
What you say his name was, Joe? Really?
Kick here as he'll try to hang it up there.
Really?
A 40-yard punt, given three on the return. And the Rams will be backed up deep to begin the drive as they take over first and 10. Set to begin their next
drive. Why is my angle changing?
At the line. There was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
We're going to keep this one. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. And the Cardinals going to use another timeout. As the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one.
he's going to keep this again. The quick throw by Burrow is...
What's up with this game?
And he will finally be taken down, but not before he reaches the 38. A big play there just before halftime. 41 yards. On first and 10, Joe Burrow flushed out right. And that's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left.
Incomplete on the throwaway. It's now second and 10.
They work again from the 38 on second and 10. Shotgun, it's Burrow, flush to his right. And he hits his running back, Tevin Coleman. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. Give him 25 yards on the play there. And it'll result in a fresh set of downs. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. The kick by McManus is good, and that will swell the lead to 16. So a capper there to a pretty good first half.
And I love the way that they put a chokehold on the clock and pretty much drained everything before they put the field goal on the board as they headed into the half.
So still time for the kickoff here. 1 second to go in the half as this one is away. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As now we send you out to Orlando and hook back up.
Hey, how do you switch out of your onside kick to a regular kick?
And how about this right out of the locker room, an onside kick attempt? And the Rams going to get the football first here, and they look to build on their lead as the second half gets started. A very interesting call and one that backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you and I both know the special teams coordinators, they sell their key plays each and every week to the head coach, don't they? Now I guarantee he's been selling this one. We can get it, coach, we can get it. And that came together with that sense of urgency you talked about.
Third quarter starts with a run from Mostert. Carry there, and it'll be second down. And
to get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
They'll stay on the ground with Mostert. They'll fight forward for a couple down inside the 40.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
From the gun on third down is Burrow. And that is incomplete.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
They're not quite in field goal range yet. They're going to go for it on fourth. They'll try and throw forward with Burrow. And he's got his tight end. That's Smith. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard.
Josiah, this dude is corny, bro.
27 yards, a big play there on fourth. Running the counter with Mostert.
That's another beautiful throw.
Yeah, but just the way he plays, like, he even did, like, some, he did the onside kick shit or whatever in, like, the second quarter and all that shit. It's just corny.
They've been on it, and they pick up another first down there.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven.
take this one in for a Rams touchdown. Joe Burrow with his second touchdown of the game and fifth on the year. And the Rams tack on to their advantage. And maybe the defense caught a little by surprise there that he took off and got in.
Yeah, I would think so, because if you're analyzing it from that side of the ball, you're thinking running back, fullback. It takes you a while before you get to the quarterback.
McManus's point.
But LaMelo dropped 30. I need a dog.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as Ed sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. On first and 10, here's Rodgers. Fuller brings it in over the middle. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. Brings up that last catch short of the marker by just a yard, leaves him with a very manageable second and 1.
What's going on? What is going on?
Nice in route. With those faster passes and they're going that fast, hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception.
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able to connect. And down inside the 15 he goes. It's another first down as they look his way again, this time 19 yards.
14-yard line.
Rodgers to throw once more. Gets this to his running back. It's Christian McCaffrey. And he'll get this down inside the 5 to the 4 before he's out of bounds. It's a gain of 9 yards. And that'll make it second and short.
Brings up second and a yard.
Rodgers again now. This will be caught at about the 5.
Rodgers pass.
Not able to get a single yard there, and it'll bring up third down. If you're going to pass down here, you better get that in the end zone.
I agree with you totally, and as we both know, the field's already condensed. There's just not a lot of space, so you've got to create some by getting some people downfield into the end zone. If you want to throw it short, you've got to have some room in order to do that. That one didn't work.
Touchdown, Arizona. Christian McCaffrey, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Cardinals cut into that lead. But CD, it seemed like they were so focused on the guys out wide that they forgot about him out of the backfield.
That's a really good point, because you've got to communicate, and oftentimes when you start counting receivers, that's exactly what you do. You start from...
And he's going to go down. Sacked back at the 13-yard line. Tried to roll out, make a play outside of the pocket, but couldn't get it done.
When you don't have a lot of space for your receivers to operate, and down there it's really condensed when you're snapping the ball from the 2-yard line, rolling out, you extend a play, but you don't necessarily open up better avenues for people. And on that play, there's just nowhere to go with the ball, and you end up getting sacked.
Now a crease here as he's past the 30. And all in all, a pretty solid return. Nearly got it to the 35. They'll mark him down officially at the 34. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And now you've got the clock winding down here in the third quarter. Your 3 scores to the good. What's your approach on this drive?
Too early to fully commit to playing the clock game. Yet at the same time, you're also not going pell-mell like you would in 2-minute offense. This is what NFL offenses call 4-minute football. Take the clock out of the game a little bit, wind it down, but at the same time, keep advancing the ball down the field.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Burrow on play action. Buying time to his left. And now he's going to use his legs. And he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35. He'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of three, but now it's third down. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. The Rams on third down. They've been good, 3 for 4 thus far. This is third and 9.
That was not fucking roughing the passer. It's ridiculous.
And finally marked down at the 42-yard line. They're down here in the fourth, and that personal foul penalty's not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration. Not a good play.
From the gun, a run with Mostert. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. Now, I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage. Work on that clock. See if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football. Gain some yardage and put the onus on the defense. But do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you?
Right, this thing about to get Mostert. Fucking... Damn, 99, the way he throwing this shit.
Eyelash dropped at the one. The end result, 21 yards. They'll run with Mostert. And he'll actually lose a little bit of yardage here. Back to the two.
Who else watching this shit?
Forthcoming. Here's third and goal.
Why is my button not working? He really just tried to run it in. He's an illegal watching you worried about the wrong thing.
Now what are we going to see on fourth?
We are soon to find out, but does this feel like...
This guy's fucking running, going on fourth and goal. Jesus. Why is nobody guarding it, bro? I'm done with this shit. Oh goodness. I had too many people. Yeah, right. On the line. Yeah, I don't know that shit. This nigga's not good at all, Joe. It's a joke. Are injuries on, Joe? Oh, wow. I need to put Fuller in my fucking kit returning.
Arizona's offense at the line, ready to get their drive started. Their mini two-game win streak appears it might be going by the wayside unless they can pull a rabbit out of their hat. Now left side on the swing pass. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
What's going on?
Rodgers now to throw. He's got Jack Doyle. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards. Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. Second and 3.
44-yard line.
They fake the give. Now Rodgers. What the? What is he doing, bro? So they're rollout shit.
Here's a throw that's taken in out of the backfield. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. Second and five after the five-yard completion on first down. Again, they'll throw with Rodgers. That's to McCaffrey, complete. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Rams 21. 12 yards there and a first down. And right side, Henry's got it. We are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. So the Cardinals, they've got the football here as we get you reset. They're looking at second down now as they search for a consolation score. And Rodgers intercepted a third time.
Hey, did this dude make his defense all X-Factors on purpose, too? Get the ball. Man, we need to take fucking injuries off, bro. This shit too fucking arcade mode to me, bro. Why is it? What is it? What is this game doing?
Chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. Now Mostert. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here.
Now that was an excellent run. And when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block. But the wide receivers, all they want to do is catch passes. So when they block on a big-time running play and create extra space, you've got to hit the jackpot there.
And he'll go down at the 28. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and it'll give him a fresh set of downs. So the L.A. Rams. Rams with a victory here. And I know I'm not breaking any news when I say that any road win in this league is a good one.
No doubt.
But it's a double bonus when you get a victory on the road in your division.
And when you start a season, each team breaks down their schedule in different ways. Some do it every four games, right? Let's go quarterly. Others say, listen, we've got to take care of our home field. And, you know, out of a 16-game season, if you get eight at home, let's at least win seven at home and split our road games. That's what you're trying to get done. So you're exactly right. A road win, precious, especially within the division.
So for L.A., it's back-to-back victories now after the Week 1 defeat as they move to 2-1. And they'll get another road date next week as their opponents will be the Seattle Seahawks. Meanwhile, for Arizona, they too will exit with a 2-1 record. And they'll get a home date next week against the Kansas City Chiefs. And for Charles Davis and our...